Blackstone Publishing presents The Alehouse at the End of the World by Stevan Allred. This book is read by Stevan Allred. Dedication for Nikki, who is my beloved. Prologue. This is an old story, a story of a tyrant and a rebellion, of monsters and humans, of love and death. Know this, there are creatures who travel back and forth from the spirit world to the land of the living. There are moments when things both sacred and mundane slip the bounds of time and pass through from one side of the mortal veil to the other. A breath of song, an ancient incantation, a blade, a bucket, a silver chain. Fate demands that it be so, and plays an endless game of gods and goddesses, of regents and rebels, of lovers and fools. The coin is tossed, spinning life and death through the air, and here, as the fire burns low and the hour grows late, the telling begins. Book 1. The Rise of King Crow. The fisherman lived alone at the edge of the sea, in a shack beneath the shade of the tallest shore pine for leagues, on a bluff above a shallow cove. All his days he had worked the sea, as a sailor and a carpenter, on ships both great and small, and as a fisherman, gill netting for the fishmongers in the port side markets, or trailing a line from his skiff to feed only himself. He had sailed all the seven seas, and sailed seven more seas beyond those, and he had seen many things. Tattooed on his arms were the names of ships he had sailed, and of sailors with whom he had weathered storms and escaped from monsters of the deep. On his chest he bore the likeness of his beloved, her face covered over now with curls of gray hair. He stood watching the waves. In his hands were a letter and a silver chain. The sea was calm that day, and light glanced in swift patches as the waves rose and broke. A thing of beauty indeed, but the fisherman had no eyes for beauty just then. The sea in front of him was thick with fish, and for that he should be thankful, but the letter in his hands had taken from him all sense of what was good about his simple life. The letter had appeared on the sand in front of his shack that morning, with no footprints leading to it, nor from it, as if it had fallen from the sky. The words were the words of his beloved, as told to her eldest son from her deathbed, and before she died, she had taken the silver chain from round her neck. "Send it to him," she'd said, "and tell him I waited. Tell him he is my one true love. Tell him I forgave him long ago, and that I will wait for him on the Isle of the Dead." He had been marooned here on this empty stretch of beach some several years, and he had given up all hope of making the arduous journey back to his beloved. It was here he would live out his meager life, or so had he thought. He put the silver chain round his neck. Fate was calling to him, telling him to find his way back to the woman he loved. He spread his arms, and he trembled in the whole of his body as tears fell from his eyes, and he turned his face to the heavens. "I surrender," he shouted. "Do with me as you will." In answer, the waves kept breaking, lapping one over the other on the wet sand at his feet. The gulls cried their shrill cries as they rode the sea breezes above him, scouting for fish. The wind blew across his bare chest and ruffled the wisps of hair on his head. To be a fisherman was to be patient, and if he had learned one thing in his years on the earth, it was to know how to wait for the answer without any irritable reaching after fact and reason. He felt the rise and fall of his chest. He hoped to hear the voice of his beloved call to him from out of the wind, but he heard only the shush of the waves breaking on the sand. Tiny crabs scuttled back and forth with the lap of the waves. The wind died down. A squadron of pelicans gathered down the beach from him, milling about, clucking and croaking to one another, gradually working their way closer until some were less than an oar.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.